State-run pension fund SSS is urging government employees, including village workers, to be part of its insurance program. Jackie Pascual has details.
Social Security System, or SSS, wants some government employees to become members of the pension fund. Its president, Rolando Makasait, said many government workers who are not regular employees or who are under a job order contract are not part of any social insurance program. And this, he said, is possibly by the millions, which include village workers.
There are 50,000 barangays in the entire Philippines, about 45. I'm rounding it off to 50,000 po, no? Ni isa dyan po, hindi miyembro ng GSIS. Lato yung barangay kapitan, pagsilbi sa bansa natin, pag after 30, 40 years po, kawawa, wala ni singko natatanggap.
A village chief in Taguig admitted to have stopped contributing to SSS for several years now after he resigned from a private company. He's glad that SSS has signed a memorandum of understanding with Taguig government so village workers may become members of SSS and their contribution will be deducted from their monthly pay, similar to the setup of private firms.
Lahat po ng empleyado ng barangay ay wala pong benepisyo makukuha mula sa SSS at GSIS either. Kasi po, hindi sila sakop since hindi kami salary. Kami po ay parang allowance lang po.
SSS hopes this new measure can add more members and help increase the fund. It targets to hit 100 billion pesos in income this year from last year's 83 billion pesos. The social insurance program also plans to extend their services to motorcycle hailing app riders, athletes, and micro-entrepreneurs so they can avail of benefits in times of need.
At birth, gusto ko may SSS number ka na eh. So kinausap ko yung PSA. Pero at the age of 18, pag kami kita ka na, pwede ka na magsimula magbayad.
Makasait added that they are also beefing up its investment portfolio for the benefit of all members. He said they may invest in projects where Maharlika Investment Corporation is also investing, but only in select and less risky projects.
Pension fund kami. Hindi kami development fund. Ine-emphasize ko yun, di ba? Ang pera ng SSS, hindi ko pwede ilagay sa mga high-risk investments. Whatever Maharlika invests in, if we feel we can invest, we can also invest.
He adds they would adopt the so-called brownfield investment or invest in existing projects as opposed to greenfield investment or new projects.
Ang SSS, hindi ko ilalagay yung pera sa isang korporasyon na nagsisimula pa lang ng construction. Halimbawa, toll road, wala pa siya. Hindi ako maglalagay pera ng SSO. Pero kung sabihin mo, si Mr. Pakilin ang sabi niya, Rolly, do you want to buy the NLEX? Oh, I like NLEX. Why? Wala ng construction risk.
Makasait is seeing a better year this 2024 with first quarter earnings already reaching 33 billion pesos. He added that they've also welcomed a million new members in the first quarter alone, a number they usually achieve in a year. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.
Farmers in the northern Philippine province of Ifugao blame the prevailing El Nino phenomenon for their stunted harvest. Lady Visoncho reports.
Farmers in Tinok, Ifugao have started harvesting carrots this cropping season. But this year, there were more crops that were stunted compared to previous years. Farmers blame the El Nino phenomenon for the lack of rainwater for their crops. Tinok Town is a rain-fed area, being one of the highest points in Ifugao province.
Medyo konti ang harvest, ma'am. Hindi masyadong malaki yung mga carrot.
Dapat maraming tubig. Para maganda, konti yung tubig kasi. No? Kasi mainit. ilang araw na na walang hindi umuulan, konti lang yung tubig na galing sa mundo.
The Environment Department said less water is also flowing down from the mountains due to deforestation as forests are being converted to vegetable gardens. The town of Tinok is known as the Salad Bowl of Ifugao, being the largest vegetable producer in the province. Data from the Municipal Agriculture Office show around 286 metric tons of Highland vegetables are being harvested in the early months of the year. The goods are being traded in agri-posts in Benguet and Nueva Vizcaya. Due to demand, farmers expand their farms through kaingin, which requires cutting and burning of trees and plants to prepare land for cultivation. Forest cover in Tinok has dwindled by 1,000 hectares in 2020 compared in 2010.
Deforestation affects only the farm located within the river basin, very near the river, because the erosion caused by deforestation destroyed or damaged our irrigation systems.
Among the factors seen as a challenge in curbing deforestation in the area is the number of indigenous people relying on farming.
Pinopromote din namin sa kanila nga hindi sana total, no, hindi massive, dapat mag-iwan tayo na mga areas for watershed. Affected ang ating tubig to support our irrigation system.
Government agencies and stakeholders are working together to protect forest reserves and prevent further deforestation in Ifugao. Lady Vicentio, ABS-CBN News.